crowd at Bud Walton Arena is big, and it is loud. And all eyes are on that new fired-up head hog, Eric Musselman, as he works to resurrect this Arkansas basketball program. But not far behind him, just a few seats up from the court, our camera is focused on his wife, Danyelle.
Come on, Jimmy. Yes. I feel like they're a little bit nervous. I don't know.
She actually would know. Before all this, before she was First Lady of Arkansas basketball, Danyelle was a sideline reporter for ESPN. She worked for Fox Sports and the NFL Network. She met Eric at a sports and media conference.
And I remember thinking, he's really nice, and ended up giving him my phone number, and it was really kind of instant. And I think just a little bit over a year later, we were married. So we knew.
That laugh. You'll hear it often during the story. Danyelle, the general manager of the Musselman home.
How do you feel you best support him?
By keeping it real.
And Danyelle is about as real as it gets.
People are already like lined up.
Whether it's in the carpool line.
Go in the back. That's ridiculous.
She brings the family dog, appropriately named Swish, to pick up their daughter Mariah from school each day. Or Mariah's Twitter account. Yes, she has one.
My husband's office runs it. She does not.
She does.
Oh, really? Okay.
She yells at refs. She has a bad attitude.
There is just no pretense. What you see is what you get. She's that way with Eric, too.
I don't think that, you know, there's too many people at the office are going to say, you know what, you're in a really bad mood. You need to snap out of it. But I say that to them.
It is clear in this Musselman era that tempo is high. During games, Coach Muss typically paces. He yells.
He's nervous. I mean, he's terrible to be around. We could go into a game and be a 30-point favorite, and he would be nervous on game day.
The intensity nearly tangible, whether the team wins or loses.
If they win, is he in a good mood?
I can ask for anything. I have like a we won list, and I just say, okay, hon, this is what I was thinking. We do need a new rug in that foyer up there. Is that fine with you? Okay, good.
And if he loses?
Then we just stay out of his way. I pretend I'm asleep a lot of the times if he comes home later than me.
Danyelle credits her Georgia upbringing for keeping her real. Her mother a nurse, her father worked for Ford. She herself played basketball. And later, as a sports reporter, she traveled the nation covering games, but ultimately hung up the mic for Eric. Her focus now is her family, with sons Michael and Matthew and daughter Mariah. Never did she dream they'd end up in Arkansas.
Was it weird calling the Hogs for the first time?
Oh, absolutely. But I love it now.
But even she was surprised at the warm welcome.
It's like nothing I've ever seen before. Walking into Bud Walton, seeing my first sellout, it gives me chills whenever I even think about it.
On the other side of that energy,
what do you want for snack?
Is something very ordinary, we learned.
I'm like, don't you want an apple?
Snack time with Mariah.
Do you want me to make it for you?
Are
you
yes, gonna please. Make
it? All of it is how Danyelle keeps balance.
Just being able to have that away from basketball, you know, sense of family time, a little sense of just normalcy, I think it just helps balance them out. I tell people we're like Netflix and chill people at the end of the day.
And Diet Pepsi people. The distributor showed up with a fridge full of product.
Oh, Muscle Milk too.
Life. As a mom in her box at Bud Walton, making sure Mariah and friends are cheering loud. And as a coach's wife, doing what she does best.
He claims that I calm him down. And so whenever I travel with him, I don't know. I don't know what it is I do. I'm just there.
Just there. There for the three-pointers, the bricks. There till the last whistle is called, she says. All of it inside this loud Arkansas arena.
I'd never want anyone to think that it's easy just because that's what you see from the outside. You just try to take a moment to enjoy everything because it all happens so fast.